We check the boxes on government forms, either married or single.
Come on, Freddie.
These days, Melissa Sugden is someplace in between.
I'm a single married person. That's what I consider myself.
It is not a marital status she ever imagined for herself when Melissa met her husband, Andy.
You know, people ask me, how long have you been married? And I said, well, we've been married 5.5 years, but we've only lived together for 4 of those years.
The faltering economy has cost some people their jobs and homes.
This is it. This is where I live.
It's landed Andy Sugden 600 miles away, below ground, in Michigan.
Yeah, I'm 37. Yeah, where are you living? Mother-in-law's basement.
Andy was a KARE 11 photojournalist up until a year and a half ago when he left the Twin Cities to become director of photography at WZZM, KARE's sister station in Grand Rapids, Michigan.
And it was exciting because, we're going to get to move back home.
Melissa grew up in Michigan, but planned to stay behind in Coon Rapids just long enough to sell the couple's home before joining her husband to start the search for a new home in Grand Rapids.
No, I never would have thought it was coming. Never would have seen this.
Their timing could not have been worse.
Well, the housing market kind of crashed, and then the job market crashed.
The home in Coon Rapids they bought in the superheated housing market 4 years ago started dropping in value about the time Andy left, and kept dropping till it was worth less than the Sugdens owed on it. And still no offers.
Man, it's sobering. It really is.
So there they sit. Andy can't move back. TV stations in the Twin Cities are laying off, not hiring.
This is just the local clients that we run.
And Melissa, also a KARE 11 employee, would face an even grimmer task finding a job in Michigan.
I always like this one.
A state with double-digit unemployment. So they talk on the phone several times a day.
Love you too.
And travel to see each other every couple of months.
I think probably the loneliest days are Sundays, because that was like our day. We always cooked dinner together.
As time passed, they split up their dogs so Andy would have company and put aside for now any thoughts of starting a family.
I would never have thought this would have been a year and a half, and it could go longer, and we're prepared for that.
I have this fear sometimes that I'll wake up at 40 and I'll still be here in this basement.
I mean, we've had family members ask us, are you going to get a divorce? And it's like they automatically assume that there's something wrong with your relationship. The economy is what's wrong with our relationship.
Andy and Melissa know things could be worse. Unlike many others, they're both still working and keeping up with their bills. They just never anticipated spending their life together apart.
Easy, bud. You know, when you take a vow and it's for better or for worse, and I wouldn't say this is necessarily the worst, but this is just the unfortunate.
Boyd Huppert, KARE 11 News, Coon Rapids.
Easy, Freddie.